Writing forms like it's 2011 sucks. You must handle many things from user experience to input validation, but with React in one useful package, you can make it 10 times better. I will show you how to create a modern example of writing forms with input validation in today's video. But first, let's take a look at a bad example of creating a form. We are storing values and errors in two separate use states, which on the first glance makes sense, but we can always make it better. The same thing is for the submitted state and the touch state. Next, it's the validation function, and again it works. But for more complex forms, it might be problematic. Here we need to add handle change and handle blur functions to handle our validations and value settings. And finally, the submit function. You already see what drawbacks it can come up with, right? So now we will look at how to make it much better for us and the end user. We will use the React hook form package, which will handle every needed aspect of forms for us. First, we need to create a form component and define a type for our form inputs. Next, we need to import the useForm hook from the package with our form values type and extract the needed states and functions from it. Now, create an onSubmit function with submitHandler type from the package and form values type. Add the handleSubmit function with this submit function into the onSubmit event in the form. Next, insert inputs like name, email, and password, and add a spreadedRegister function with field name and requirements, followed by error messages. Repeat these steps for every input you need to create. Finally, add the submit button to the form, and now, as we can see, the form is working fine. It is much cleaner now, right? But we can take it to a higher level using Zod. First, we need to install Zod and hook form resolvers packages. Import these packages into our form, and then we need to create a Zod schema. In the schema, we define field names by specifying what type is this field and what requirements are needed for this input. For the name input, we will also add the name is taken check. We can do it using the refine function. For demo purposes, I will only check if the name is John. Repeat these steps for every input you have in your form, then scroll to the useForm hook and add resolver with Zod resolver and the created schema. Also, change the mode to onBlur to make form validation when input focus is lost. Finally, just delete requirements from the register function and inputs. As we can see, the validation is working just fine, also with the name availability check. And just like that, we created a much better form than the beginning. If you like this video, consider subscribing and leaving a like. See you in the next one.